वेलकम टू आवर चैनल लाइफ इनसाइट्स। दिस टाइम वी आर फेस्ड विद द क्वेश्चन, इज देयर एनीथिंग कॉल्ड एज सैक्रेडनेस इन आवर लाइफ? इज देयर एनीथिंग कॉल्ड एज गुडनेस इन आवर लाइफ? इज देयर एनीथिंग कॉल्ड एज फ्लावरिंग इन आवर लाइफ? इज देयर एनीथिंग बियॉन्ड टाइम एंड डेथ? लेट अस explore into these questions. To understand better, we take the life history of Lord Buddha. When Lord Buddha was young, he was given the name Siddhartha. Siddhartha was the son of a king. His father came to know that one day he would become a sannyasi in search of truth. So he wanted to stop this. Hence, he took care of his son like anything. One day Siddhartha saw somebody carrying a dead body. He was thinking that he would always remain young. But he found out that one day he would become old and will meet with death. So his curiosity arose. Then it became that his only aim in life was to find out the truth. What is the truth behind all these phenomenal happenings? That was only his aim. One day, without telling anybody, he left the royal home. He went to many masters. He asked so many questions. He had been told to meditate for long hours. Whatever has been told, he did. He tried and tried. Later, it was said that he found out the truth. Later, he preached this truth in the name of Buddhism. It is said that he found out Nirvana. Nirvana is the answer for all the questions regarding life. To find the secret of life, we are to be with Nirvana. Nirvana he called as nothingness. So when we attain to nothingness, all our problems will disappear. Nothingness is beyond time and superficial life. Now what he did, find it out. He found that the root cause of all the problem is our own mind. Mind is always chattering, chattering and chattering. So he inquired why this happens. Mind is filled with so many thoughts. So he experimented with the thought process and found that thought process is the real cause of all the suffering. He experimented with suffering because suffering is the major problem of humanity. Today also we are faced with the phenomenon called terrorism. Terrorism is the highest form of suffering. We are faced with wars. War is the highest form of suffering. Then Lord Buddha inquired why human beings are suffering like anything. What is the basic reason for all these kind of sufferings? His inquiry was very much genuine. To find the secret in life, the core of our life, that he found as nothingness or Nirvana. Now what is Nirvana? How it can be attained? Nirvana is a state beyond our own mind. We can call this one as no mind. If mind is there, there must be a state called as no mind. Now what kind of no mind is this? When we go beyond our own thought process, we will come to the state called nothingness, the ultimate silence in life, the ultimate flowering in our life. This is beyond all the dualities of life. If we observe the existence, existence is always blissful because that is the only option for the existence. But man has always two options. I can be sad or I can be happy. I can celebrate the life. Or I can be endless in sorrow. Which way we are to go? Only we have the option to select. So we are to look into our own mind and how it functions. First of all, we have to decide what we want in our life. In all the aspects of life, mind creates more and more. Even if we get the whole world, we will not be able to be happy. Then, what is the secret of happiness? Lord Buddha experimented with all these kind of good questions and found that desires are the root cause of all the problems. He experimented with desires. He understood what is the process known as desire in our mind. And lastly, he found the reason for all these kind of happenings. So there is a stage in our life called sacredness. Sacredness is what creation is. Creation is the greatest order in our life. Our day-to-day life is faced with so many disorders like poverty, violence, terrorism, etc. But when we attend to creation, attend to creativity, we will be able to go beyond time and death. That is what Nirvana is. That is the significance of our own life. Our brain has the capacity to attain this. For that, an observing mind with awareness is only needed. That is the reality of life which Lord Buddha could find it out. Once again, we will come up with another one video describing another aspect of life.